How do you set up the Apple Vision Pro if you're blind or visually impaired, and what is it like? Let's talk about it. Hi everyone, this is Carrie on Accessibility, and I talk about accessibility and technology. If you're interested in that type of video, hit the subscribe button and the bell so you can be notified every time I upload a video. And we're going to be doing quite a bit of Apple Vision Pro content. I've had the Vision Pro for over a week now, and I've gone through setup about four times now. This will be my fifth. I'm going to set it up with you guys, and unfortunately during setup there's no way to screen record, but hopefully I can make it loud enough so at least you'll be able to hear VoiceOver. This is not a review or talking about what it can do. I did talk about it in my first impressions live stream. It has chapters now, so go ahead and check that out if you're interested. So first, here is the device. You're gonna wanna put it on. And there's only two buttons. There's the digital crown. You'll feel it. You can rotate it. You can press it. It's very similar to what's on the Apple Watch. And then on the left side, there is basically a camera shutter button. So you want to put it on. And it starts making noise. That's the first thing that will happen. And there's something on the screen. It looks like an outline of something, and I can see maybe white text. I can't see anything that's on it.
Triple click the digital crown for VoiceOver.
It will say triple click the digital crown for VoiceOver after some time. And I really like that it says that, so that no matter what type of user you are, whether you are somebody who uses VoiceOver or not, Apple makes it very clear how to enable accessibility. So that is a really great step. Thank you, Apple. So I'm going to go ahead and triple press that crown.
VoiceOver. Lock view. Aligning your view. Double click digital crown to align manually.
Right now it says aligning your view, probably because my eyes move around a lot, it can't align it automatically, so I will have to double press the crown to do it manually.
Lock view.
From here, there's some adjusting of the inner screens of the ones that you're looking at. For me, I really can't tell the difference, so I'm just going to double press that crown.
Welcome to VoiceOver. VoiceOver speaks descriptions of items in Apple Vision Pro. To learn more about VoiceOver on Apple Vision Pro, tap your left index finger against your left thumb and then release. If you are familiar with VoiceOver, pinch and hold your right middle finger against your right thumb. To turn VoiceOver off, press the digital crown. VoiceOver tutorial.
So now I can see some text that's really big in front of me. It's in cursive. It's very similar to Apple setup. And if you have VoiceOver on, it will start taking you through the tutorial right away. I suggest that you make sure to go through the tutorial if you don't know how to use the gestures for the Vision Pro. It's really important. And one hugely important thing is make sure you hold your hands like a cup, like you're holding a cup in both hands. You will need to have both hands. For most things, you can do a lot with one hand, like going to next and previous item and activating items. I'll be talking about VoiceOver and other accessibility features in a separate video, but for now I just want to make sure that you're able to go through the tutorial. The first time I went through setup, it was really challenging because I did not have my hands in that kind of C position, and that's really important because it will move around and do things that I don't mean it to do, because I guess I move my hands a lot. And you don't really want to do that. You really want to be cognizant of the cameras are staring at your hands, trying to figure you out and trying to be responsive to your hands. Another important thing is these are floating windows. The tutorial itself is a floating window, and you may hear the spatially it's to your left or to your right, or there's just some positioning in the sound, and you can ignore that. VoiceOver should still work. Sometimes it's all the way to my left. I have to do like a 90 degree turn of my whole body so that I can see the VoiceOver tutorial. not that I can actually really see it, but it's something about like looking at the window and having the audio spatially sound like I'm looking at it, right? So I'm gonna turn VoiceOver back on.
Hello. Press crown to begin.
So we can press the crown to begin. I'm going to skip the tutorial and I'm gonna press the crown to begin.
Setup. Bring iPhone or iPad nearby to get started.
So here I have my iPhone, but unfortunately I can't use Face ID on my iPhone because I have the Vision Pro on. I can take it off for a moment and lift my face out of there.
Set up Apple Vision Pro heading.
And
unlock to continue.
I have to unlock my phone to continue.
Face ID.
I can get my Face
Dynamic
ID.
Empty. Waiting for Apple Vision Pro.
And now it says waiting for Apple Vision Pro. So I'll put the Apple Vision Pro back on, and this is probably messing up my hair.
Look here with Apple Vision Pro.
Okay, look here with Apple Vision Pro. I have to...
Continue setting up on Apple Vision Pro. Heading.
There we go, and they had a QR code, and the Vision Pro scanned it.
Video. Activate to toggle controls.
Then it will auto launch a video, and it will talk to you. Sometimes VoiceOver does talk over it.
Press the digital crown to set.
The next step is to press the digital crown so you can set up your eyes and hands, and this is supposed to make it more responsive to gestures and also make the eye tracking better. You can also press the top button, which is what they call like the shutter button on the top left when you're wearing the device. You can also triple press that button to open accessibility. From there, you can turn on zoom and other motor and motion and hearing accessibility features. However, I wouldn't be able to see the accessibility menu. I would need VoiceOver to go through that accessibility menu. The most important VoiceOver gestures is a index to thumb pinch, that's next item, middle to thumb pinch, that's previous item, and ring finger to thumb pinch, and that is to activate like a double tap, and that's all with your right hand. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to set up the hands and eyes tracking. I press the digital crown.
Extend your arms in front of you with your fingers spread and the backs of your hands facing Apple Vision Pro.
And what you want to do is move your hands kind of like you're trying to get like a high five or a 10-5 and away from you so that it can scan your hands.
Set up. Flip your hands over.
And you want to make sure your fingers are spread. And then it'll ask you to flip your hands in the same position. It's going to scan your hand.
Hand setup complete.
And then once you're done with that, it will start eye setup. I skipped this because it doesn't work for me and I can't see it anyway. So I'm gonna go next.
To help with this, skip eye setup.
Skip eye setup. I'm gonna activate that button.
3D photos of your face and upper body from setup later. Get started. Setup later. Button.
The next step is to set up persona. You take off the headset and it will basically map out your face so that it can display your face on the outer screen. I'm not really interested in doing that, so you can always skip this one. The next step is optic ID. It's basically like face ID, but since, you know, it can't really scan your face, as soon as you put it on, it will scan your irises. And this doesn't work for me or somebody with aniridia. Or probably it's my nystagmus, so this is also something that I typically skip.
Set up later in settings.
You can always set this up later in settings.
Passcode field is editing. 0 of 6 values enter.
Then you can also set up a passcode. There's actually a way to skip this because each time you take off the headset or you even lift it off your head for a moment just to fix your hair or something, it'll ask for your passcode. So I don't like to put a passcode. I'm gonna go backwards with VoiceOver.
A passcode, create a passcode, passcode, image, options.
And you're going to go to options, activate that. You can choose a 4-digit numeric code,
custom
alphanumeric code, or don't use passcode. And that's the one that I'm going to choose. It'll, of course, give you an alert. And then you just have to activate the don't use passcode button. And I'm pretty sure it's red. I'm going to activate that one.
Don't use data and privacy.
And then there's a data and privacy notice here. And you can just accept. And then it says it could take a few minutes. It really doesn't. There's some safety tips. For example, it says Stay aware of your surroundings. Use in safe areas. Don't drive with it. Don't use it if you're feeling discomfort or motion sickness. I'm always discomfort with this, but that's another story. But that's okay.
Apple Vision Pro is to continue.
And we'll go continue.
Setting up Apple ID.
Then it says setting up Apple ID. There's some more terms and conditions.
Please read the following. A. Vision OS terms and conditions. Please read disagreement. If you do not agree, the toolbar.
There's a disagree and agree. So I'm going to activate agree.
I agree to the Vision OS terms. Agree.
And I press agree a second time.
Setting up Apple ID.
And it says setting up Apple ID.
Enjoy your Apple Vision Pro. Heading.
Heading.
And there's my iPhone saying, enjoy your new Apple Vision Pro.
Choose how you want to transfer apps and data.
You can transfer apps and data. I don't do that one.
Settings. Customize. Continue.
And then you can press continue.
Only download on. Continue.
And then you can choose how you're going to handle updates, if it's going to be automatic. I'm going to press continue.
Siri and dictation. Heading. Help improve Siri and dictation by allowing Apple to store your audio interactions.
You can also choose to improve Siri or dictation, so it's going to take your recordings and send it to Apple. I'm going to say not now.
iCloud Analytics. Heading.
There's iCloud Analytics.
Apple improve its products and search about iCloud Analytics. Don't share.
You can share analytics or not share. I'm going to choose not share.
Don't. Appearance. Heading.
Says appearance. This is basically your display size. They're small,
medium,
large, or extra large. I'm going to select extra large. You can change this in settings.
Continue button.
And then there's a continue button.
Set up. Next.
Next, it takes you through different tips. So how to use the app placement bar at the bottom. And then after that, it teaches you how to make windows larger. There's a, if you focus on the corner on the bottom left or bottom right of a window, you can expand or make the window smaller. The next tip is to press and hold the digital crown and it'll center your view, basically move the app that you're working on in the middle of your view. The next one, it explains the control center. There's a little arrow. If you look up with the Vision Pro, there's supposed to be a little arrow, and that's how you activate the control center. The last tip is how to close windows. There's a little dot next to the app placement bar. If you focus on it, it will turn into an X button, and then you can activate that to close windows. And then it says, welcome, press crown to enter home. And you just press the crown.
Control center, expand menu.
And then you are all set up. Whew. Hopefully that gives you an idea of how the setup goes on the Apple Vision Pro. In my experience, sometimes it's pretty easy, like how it was this time. Other times it was really difficult because it would not scan whatever I did. I asked my mom to help me. I asked her to try to scan the QR code from the iPhone and it would not do it. So when it works, it's absolutely great. But when it doesn't work, you have to enter your Apple ID and password manually on the keyboard, and the keyboard is not the easiest thing on the Vision Pro. I think it's a pretty good setup, all things considered. The most challenging thing for me was learning VoiceOver. And again, I will be talking about accessibility in another video, so stay tuned for that one. That's pretty much it for this one. If you liked it, make sure to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks everybody, and I'll catch you in the next one.